Just doing a little cleanup work here before we go on to the next steps. Looking good. Okay, today what we'll do, we'll finish the ears and we'll finish the nose, which we'll do right now. Starting right back here, we want to get those two nostrils sort of outlined. Now here's an instance where understanding the grain of the wood comes in. You know, I went like this down to here. I can't go any farther. If I go down here, it's going to chip out, so I have to turn around and do it this way. See, and that creates a nice looking nostril. So I'll do that over here. Again, I have to stop, turn it around. Just evening things up there. Okay, we've got his nostrils fairly outlined on top. Now we just do it on the bottom. Now how I do this is I don't want a hole. All I want is a shadow line down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just come down here and take out a chip. You see, that creates a shadow line there for the nostril. And that's really all you need.
You're holding it this way.
Right there. So we'll do the same thing over here. Make sure we get them even. One reason it's not even is this side's a lot thicker than that side, so I'm going to have to cut it down. Getting there. Okay. Looking at it from the top, I can see a problem. It's not a problem, but I can see some work after this. See how this one is lower than this side over here? We'll want to even that out. There, it's much better. Much better. Now on his jaw down here, you can see how this one goes in more than this one over here. We have to even that out. Establish our muscle line there. Yep, that looks a lot better. Okay. For the ears. I do a pretty simple ear, as you'll see here. Make sure we got those lined up. This needs to come down just a little. That's good. Coming straight in right here, like that. I'm going to cut up and kind of lay my knife over as I come around, so it just sort of bleeds right out to the top of the wood. Just like that. Here, I'm just going to outline this whole little globe. Like that. Here, just going to make a little stab mark in there and take out a chip. Do the same thing up here. Get rid of my pencil line. See that? Now what we're going to do is we're going to shape the ear into a more recognizable. Starting about here, I'm going to scoop out a little area right there. There we have a pretty nice looking ear. I can actually come over here a little deeper. Make that look a lot better. Get off of this pointy, kind of comes to a point there, which I don't like. There, let's round it off. See, that makes a nice looking ear, very simple. And then you can come back and you can make the ear a lot thinner. You don't want a real thick ear out there. There, nice looking ear. Okay. I'm gonna kind of soften these sideburns up. That one's really thick, so I'm gonna cut it down just a bit. Let's go ahead and do this one. Now this one, you sort of have to do it in reverse. So I lay my knife down, and as I come around, I straighten it up. Take that chip out there. Kind of messy, but most of that's the pencil on. My knife's getting a little dull. Okay, same thing on the other side. We come down here and we scoop out that back. Narrow our ears down again. You might want to wait on this step till you get the carving pretty well done. That way you don't have to worry about something getting chipped off. There you go. Now. Take a little break here for a second. Okay, I pulled up the picture of Teddy Blue before it was painted, so I can look at his eyes, because you can't see his eyes. I'm looking at it here. Funny, boy, they just don't even look the same, do they? Not because they're painted. The characters just don't look the same. Look at this picture, you think his eyes are wide open. Here he's in kind of a squint. But anyway, we're going along here pretty good. So what I'm going to do now is I just wanted to establish the eyebrow line. Because what's indicated on the carving now is way too high. Okay. So, I need a sharp pencil here. I'll sharpen my pencil. About here's where I want to do his eyes. These eyes now, if I had that carving, you're not really going to even be able to see them, but we're still going to carve them. I mean, people will look in there, and maybe someday someone will try to take his glasses off, and his eyes will be there. So, I'm just going to change it a little. Distract him. Bald, isn't he? Okay. Like I always say, remember that the eyes in the skull are set in a hole like that. Okay? It's kind of not the best skull, but it's good for... And as a ball sits in this. And there's the ball, right there. And the eyes sit within that. So what we want to do is we want to create that ball. Just like that. And that's going to give us the platform on how to carve the eyes, which is very simple. Everybody thinks eyes are hard to do. They're not at all if you just understand anatomy again, how important that is. So I'm going to make a cut here and come up like that and take that chip out like that. See, there you can already see the ball. Now down here, I'm not going to cut so deep. Just do it shallow. Okay, now we kind of round that out a little. And there we have our eye platform. Okay, now we're going to do the same thing over here. It's a little heavy on this side, so I'm going to shave that down. here, aside from a few little tags. So there we got our two platforms for the eyes, and before I go any farther, I'm going to go over and buff my knife blade a little, because I want my knife to be super sharp when I'm working on this area. It's sharp now, but it's not super sharp. So, I'm going to go buff up my knife blade. Okay, my knife is super sharp now. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do the eyes. So, whoop, don't like that one. Yeah, that one's better. This is these upper eyelash. This side's a little high. My knife is super sharp. Still high. Okay, so here we go. Anyway, now this is one time that, you know, I carve straight into the wood. Don't do that very often, but this is one time that I do. So I'm just going to cut in there like that, following that pencil line like that. And then I'm going to take that chip out. Turn it around, do the same thing over again. Looks pretty good. Again, this one's a little high right here. Now the lower eyelid. Again, straight in. And we take the chip out about halfway up. And there in the corner, try to go a little deeper and get that corner chip out, because that gives you a real nice definition. It turns your eyeball into a ball. And the same thing on the other side. The secret to a good eye is not having to go back and do something. There. Now we do the same thing over here. Take the chip out. Take the corner out. Line. This one's a little narrower. Now what I like to do is I'm going to bring this lash out just a little further, and this one too, and right here I'm going to curl, make it look like this lower part goes in underneath the other part, upper part. Like that. Now I'm going to come here and just make a curl up. That just makes that eye look better. I can actually go in there and make that go underneath there even more. So that's looking good. So now I'm going to give it a little, indicate a lash down here by real lightly. Just put my knife there. And whatever you do, if you're going to do this, always come down from the weakest point, which is right there. Always carve to away from the weakest point. Real gently. The makes them look nice. Oh, watch out there. See, that's what happens. And I was doing it right. Clean that up. Happens to all of us. Okay, so now we can come out here, give him some laugh lines. It's bright out there in the sun, that's why he's got his sunglasses on. Right here, don't show up so much. I think I still have Teddy Blue's picture on here. Right there, see that line? Right there. That's what we want to get now. And that's about right there. So we'll just take a little indentation and spin it out. Looking pretty good. Looking pretty good. Now with my other knife, I'm going to come up here and give him some age lines up here on top of his head. One more thing I want to do is down here underneath, right in this area here, if you look at people, you can see just a little bit of it right here. See that line right there? It's on all my carvings, it just don't show up. It's even on Teddy Blue here. Right there it is, see? On each side. It's kind of partially hidden with the sideburns, but we still need to add it because it's just a little carving area that makes a heck of a difference on your carving. Starting shallow out here, go deep. And then come back up like that. And then just out off the outer edge, go down to the center. and take that out. And then kind of real lightly bring that chip right on down. See, look how much character that added to his face. I'm going to do the same thing over here, deep, and then come out shallow. And carve down to the line. Get the chip out. Whatever you do, don't ever forget to get rid of that. I think I've told you once before, I had someone come in to buy a carving, and they would have bought it. They turned that thing over and saw that sawn area, and they set that carving back down, and I lost the sale. Hopefully you see that show up pretty good. Let me get it down here on the floor. I think it shows up better out of so much harsh light. Looks pretty good, I think. So tomorrow, or whenever, we'll do his hair, and that'll finish the head, and then we'll start work on the body, and then the hat. So until then, I'll talk to you later.